Hello, students. Today I'm going to show you how to access resources available to you through the databases through the El Camino Library. So let's get started. First of all, I'm on the El Camino website and I'm going to scroll down to the bottom here and click Library. You can also access this page directly through Canvas. There's a toolbar on the left side, a menu on the left side that says ECC Library. You can click on that and it will take you to this page. So you'll notice right away that this first field, the one search field, looks a little bit different than it did last semester. So that's why I'm doing this tutorial to help you navigate. In the past, I would have suggested going right to one search and putting in your keywords there. But I've run into a few difficulties with having to log in and having some difficulties with that. So I'm going to suggest instead that you navigate directly to the library databases instead, for the time being at least. So I'm going to click on Library Databases. And here I will get a list of all sorts of databases available to us. So I'm going to start with the Academic Search Complete. It's the very first one, and it has a wealth of information that most of you will find useful for your papers. So now I have the search field, and I'm going to type in my keywords. In my case, I'm going to search for food insecurity because I'm concerned about hunger, and I want to focus my results specifically on the United States. I am not looking at worldwide. I just want to look at what's in the US. So you'll notice over on the left, I've got some checkboxes, source types, some ways I can refine my results. So I'm going to refine my results because I want something that is recent, because I might have to use something that was published in the last 2 years. So if I change my date to 2018 to 2020, now I'm going to get results that are have been published within the last 2 years, so they're very recent. You'll notice here on the left it will tell me the kind of source it is. So these are all academic journals. That won't always be the case, but I just happen to have a list here that's a lot of academic journals. Here is obviously the title of the article. If I click on this, I'm going to get a little bit more information so I can decide if this is something that I think I might want to use. So I have the abstract here, which is sort of a summary of what the article is about. And already I like this article because it deals with college students and food insecurity, which is of interest to me. I have the article here. I can also listen to it if I want to hear it read. But I like this article by glancing at it. I think it's something I might use. So I'm going to look at the PDF full text version. It's a little bit easier to read, I think. And so I may not read the whole thing right now. I just want to gather my initial resources. So I'm going to probably email these to myself. I could print them. I could save them to Google Drive. I would actually probably do that. You can do whatever it is you like. But one thing I do suggest you do is create your citation for your Works Cited page right away. So if I look over to this button on the right, it says cite. If I hover over it, and then I have many different formats. We're using MLA. So if I scroll down to MLA, I can copy this citation and put it in a rough works cited page right now. If I later decide this is not a source I'm going to use, it's very easy to remove it, but it's much easier to remove it than to have to go back and recreate it. So just do this as you're gathering your information. I think that's the easiest. So let's go back to the databases really quickly. You'll see there are many others here. 60 Minutes, if you want some videos, if you're working with health related topics, which I know a few people are. Health Source Consumer Edition is a nice one. I was asked to log in when I was looking at sources earlier, but I was able to email myself an article without logging in. So I suggest you try that. And then one other database I wanted to let you know about, Films on Demand. This one's kind of interesting too, if you're looking for videos or films, either for your research papers or there may be some films that you're interested in as entertainment, and you might be able to find them here. So, but even with food insecurity, if I type that in, if I spell it correctly, and I will discover that there are some segments here that I might be able to use as a source for my paper as well. So hopefully that helps you get a jump start on your research paper and the research piece of it. If you run into any difficulties or have any questions, please let me know. Good luck.